Myself, Dipali. Chapter 8, Quadrilaterals, Class 9. We are going to do exercise 8.1, question number 8 in this session. ABCD is a rectangle in which diagonals AC bisect angle A as well as angle C. Show that ABCD is a square and diagonal BD bisects angle B as well as angle D. That is what we are supposed to prove here. Now, let us take the diagram first. It is a rectangle and we are drawing the diagonals AC and BD. So A, B, C and D, and the two diagonals are given to us. Now we are supposed to prove ABCD is a square and diagonals ABD bisect angle B and angle D. Now let us label this as angle 1 and angle 4. And this is angle 2 and angle 3. So now we know that given to us is quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle and AC bisects angle A and angle C. Therefore, angle 1 is equal to angle 4 and angle 2 is equal to angle 3. This is what is given to us. Now, first we have to prove that ABCD is a square. So, we know that since quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram as well. Now, therefore, AB is parallel to CD and AC is transversal. Therefore, angle 4 is equal to angle 2 and angle 1 is equal to angle 3. They are alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Now, but from result 1, or what is given to us, we know angle 1 is equal to 4 and angle 2 is equal to 3. Therefore, angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Now, in triangle ABC, therefore, AB is equal to BC. That means the two adjacent sides are equal and opposite sides are already equal. Similarly, we can prove for CD is equal to DA. Now, as ABCD is a parallelogram, adjacent side is a rectangle having adjacent sides equal, therefore it is a square. So now quadrilateral ABCD, which is a rectangle with adjacent sides equal, therefore quadrilateral ABCD is a square. Our first result is proved. Let us prove the second result. For second result, we have, now we know that quadrilateral ABCD is a square Therefore, diagonals bisect the opposite angles. Therefore, BD will bisect angle B and angle D. Hence, it is proved. Let us do the ninth sum. Now, in ninth question, we have the parallelogram ABCD, two points P and Q are taken on the diagonals BD such that BD is DP is equal to BQ as shown in the figure. You have to prove the following five results: that triangle APD, that is triangle APD, is congruent to triangle CQB, AP is equal to CQ, then triangle AQB is equal to triangle CPD, and AQ is equal to CP, and APCQ is a parallelogram. This is what we are supposed to prove. So first, let us draw the figure. So we have here A, A A B C and D and diagonal BD, and on that diagonal we have point Q and point P, and so we have these lines which are joining it like this way, that is AQ and AP, and CQ and CP. Now let us solve it. Now in the first one, we know that it is a parallelogram. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Therefore, BD is diagonal and PD is equal to QB is given to us. Now first one we need to prove. So AD is parallel to BC and BD is transversal. Therefore, angle ADB will be equal to angle CBD. They are in alternate interior angles. And therefore, angle ADP is equal to angle CBQ because P and Q lie on it. Now, in triangle APD and triangle CQB, AD is equal to CB. They are opposite sides of parallelogram. Then we have PD is equal to QB. It is given to us, and angle ADP is equal to angle CBQ. We already proved it above. Therefore, triangle APD is congruent to triangle CQB, that is by SAS congruency. That is our first result. Now, second result is already proved. We know that now triangle APD is congruent to triangle CQB, which we already proved. Therefore, AP is equal to CQ by CPCT. Now, for the third result, let us take AB is parallel to CD and BD is transversal . Therefore, angle ABD is equal to angle CDB. Angle ABQ is equal to angle CDP. Now, in triangle AQB and triangle CPD, QB is equal to PD is given to us. Angle ABQ is equal to angle CDP that we have already proved, and AB is equal to CD. They are opposite sides of parallelogram. Therefore, triangle AQB is equal to triangle CPD by SAS congruency. Hence, our third result also is proved. Now, fourth result, we know triangle AQB is congruent to triangle CPD by above result. Therefore, AQ is equal to CP by CPCT. And fifth result, from the above result in quadrilateral, we have triangle PCQ in quadrilateral APCQ, opposite sides are equal, as we already proved that. Therefore, quadrilateral APCQ is a parallelogram. Hence, it is proved. So, that was our question number 8 and question number 9. Thank you for now.